This give a kind of nice smoky flavor. So what we do is we want that nice sizzling sound. We just put a piece of butter. Now you know where the smoke comes from. This is how a sizzler is served. You know, the butter gives the smoke. Now I have this nice kati roll in which the chicken kebab is there. Namaste, salam alaikum, sastri akal. Welcome back to another session with your Vahchef at whatever.com. And today, I'm going to show you how to make this awesome Hariyali kebab. You know, for this, we're going to add some oil in a pan. Once you add the oil in this, we're going to add some cashew nuts. In this, we're going to need some binding. So we're going to use two binding. One is the cashew nut and the other one is fried chana dal powder. You know, I use fried chana dal powder in a lot of recipes where they add chana dal flour, because this powder is already roasted and it has got the nice sweet flavor. So in this, we're going to add garlic. Slowly fry this till the cashew nut gets light color. Look at this, slightly the cashew nut has got the color. In this, we're going to add a little bit of coconut powder. Do not add too much. Coconut powder is just to give the flavor. So in this, we're going to add green chili. You know, the spicy green chili will make this kebab very, very tasty. Along with this, we're going to add curry leaf. You know, you can add actually a lot of curry leaf in this to give a very nice flavor for this kebab. In this, add lot of coriander and mint. So this coriander and mint, we have to slowly cook it because we want this to become a nice paste. You cannot make a silky paste if the leaf is not cooked. Even with the spinach, when we want to make a nice gravy, we always cook the spinach and make the paste. Otherwise, it will be grainy and the water will be getting separated. Look at this. The leaf is getting roasted in this. Once this is getting roasted, in this, add the chickpea flour. Not too much, that should be good enough. And also, add some salt. Okay? Once you add a little bit of salt, and now we're going to let this all cool down. Just going to fry a little bit, and the cashew nut and the fried chickpea flour also gives a very nice taste and the binding. And we're going to put in a blender and going to make a paste out of it. You know, for a malai kebab, you know, I want you to go back and see this malai kebab video. I thought it will be like a super hit, but that is the best kebab in India. So now this curry leaf and then the mint and everything, the paste is ready. Add as much as possible. And you know, you can leave little bit in the blender. I'm going to show you why. So in this, just squeeze in a little bit of lime juice and just make sure the chicken pieces, of course, I forgot to tell you, you know, for this kebab, you know, just cut the chicken pieces into small size pieces. So here I'm going to use the leg meat also. For murgh malai kebab, I use only breast meat. Apply all this masala. This is nice. The salt is everything perfect. And this chicken, I have brined the chicken. Always, when you get the chicken from the market, just take a bowl, add some salt and water, and let this chicken rest in that water for 2-3 hours. Then the chicken will become nice and tender. Later, you make any fry, kebabs, anything, it will be perfect. You know, look at this. Nice chicken coated. This chicken is ready. I'm going to keep it on the side. And see, whatever little paste that is left, you can convert that into nice mint raita. So just add a little bit yogurt and mix this, and it will become a nice raita. You can serve it with the kebabs or anything. And this one you can serve as a mint raita, and it will taste excellent. You know, what we do is we take the wooden skewers like this and just make sure put this chicken pieces onto a skewer. What I often feel comfortable is just you know, use two skewers. The first one, you just put it in, and whatever the losing, hanging ends of the meat, just put the second skewer. That way you will be able to put it in the oven easily. Look at them, very perfect. And leave little bit gap, you know. Don't stick them all together. Just leave little bit gap, that way these kebabs will cook better. Any of the marinade that is left, slowly spread it on top of this chicken, so it'll be good enough. This is all ready to go into the oven. Because there is small amount of oil, you can first cook it for like 15 minutes. After that, turn it aside and take little bit oil or butter and baste it while cooking, and your nice Hariyali tikka or Hariyali kebab will be ready, and later I'm going to show you how to serve it. These kebabs, you know, I put it in the oven, but if you want to give a nice little bit of smoky flavor, we can always put this on the direct flame to give nice smoky flavor. And you know, whatever little bit oil that is there, that also you can give a coat. Just apply a little bit of butter and cook it on both sides. So this awesome Hariyali kebab is very famous in Hyderabad in some restaurants. So one of the viewers asked, and I, the corporate chef of that hotel is my friend, so I took the recipe from him, the way they make it there, and that is what I'm showing. Slowly, you know, a little bit of flame also is good. This give a kind of nice smoky flavor, just for the, you know, finishing touch. This is how our kebabs will be ready. But let this sit here. I'm going to make nice Hariyali kati roll. So to make a kati roll, first take a tawa, apply little bit of butter, you know, make a chapati, you know, very soft chapati, and just put it on this, beat an egg, pinch of salt, and this is what we are going to pour on the kati roll. Now just apply a little bit butter, just turn it to the other side. We are just going to pour in some egg, okay, for the kati rolls. So we need to make a kind of little bit, one egg should be more than enough. Just spread it well, put a little bit of butter, let this egg slightly kind of thicken. Now turn it to the other side, switch off the flame, and now we are going to make our kati roll. So once the egg is all done, put this Hariyali tikka on this, some onions, some bell pepper, and I have got cheese mayo, a little bit, not too much. And now all we do is, for our kati roll, just roll it in very hot. Oh, make a kati roll like this, and apply a little bit of butter. We are going to serve this along with sizzler kebab. Sizzler is all ready, on which we are going to serve our Hariyali kebab. So just be very, very careful. This is hot. On this, we are going to put some, you know, cabbage. Usually, you know, they put some lettuce or so on. In this, you can also put a bigger piece of lettuce. And on this, we are going to add some onion, some vegetable, a piece of lemon, and we are going to put the hot chicken. This is all good. The Hariyali kebab on a skewer. So what we do is, we want that nice sizzling sound. We just put a piece of butter. Now you know where the smoke comes from. This is how a sizzler is served. You know, the butter gives the smoke, and we have the hot sizzler and then the kebab. Now I have this nice kati roll in which the chicken kebab is there. Squeeze in some lemon juice and nice Hariyali kebab. Make sure you make these awesome kebabs at home. Eat it with your family and keep saying Vareva.